I don't think people learn to be an animal lover. I think it's just something that you have in you. Kiera's hope will hopefully be a sanctuary for senior and abused dogs, but we would never ever turn anything down or away. My vision for the sanctuary is somewhere on a farm, acreage, with a bunch of outbuildings, lots and lots and lots of fields that will be fully fenced for them to run, for them to play. Well, the way I see it, I wouldn't treat them any differently than I do my own dogs. The whole point behind Kiera's Hope is to put these dogs in a situation where they can be relaxed, where they feel like they're at home. This is something that really needs to be done, and I'm going to do it. I think the biggest obstacle is getting it out there, getting people to know about what I'm trying to do. You know, if people don't know, then they can't contribute or donate or buy a ticket or a t-shirt or a bracelet. Kiera, just saying her name makes me start to cry. Okay, so she was a pup that, She was perfect. She had an adverse reaction to a vaccine when she was 18 months old, and it was very extreme. They didn't think that she was going to make it. But in the end, she defeated all of their thoughts on it. She lived another 8 years after she had this adverse reaction. And so it just went from there. She started to grow in leaps and bounds. Things started to come back. She could never lead a sled team again. She always dragged her back foot. So what we always did was at the end of a run, we would slow the babies down. She would meet up with us and we had her lead them home. She was a dog that if I asked her to pull for 100 miles and she had only ever pulled for 25 before that, she would have pulled for 100 miles. That was her. She never said, I can't do it. And that was probably the biggest inspiration she gave to me was, you don't ever quit. And I think that's what means the most to me. There are so many shelters out there, and not just shelters, there's so many charities out there. It's very hard to distinguish yourself and get people engaged and wanting to focus on what you're doing. I think we need to start focusing on people who maybe don't have 100 dogs, maybe they only have 20, but they have the time, the patience, and the expertise to bring those dogs out so that they can move on to their future home so that you can bring in another 20. And I think that's what's key. And I think that's what makes Kiera's Hope different. If those dogs never ever leave, it's okay. Because the day that they die, I will be there. And I'll be hugging them. And I'll be telling them how much they're loved. And they will know that that's the absolute truth.